today. How important is it to have Jeff White back?
Oh, look, he's very important to us, as is Daniel Ward and Nathan Brown. Give us a bit of run. But it's going to take 22 players out there rather than just relying on Neats and White, and that's what we're looking for today.
How comfortable is White in his new shin guard?
Oh, look, he's really comfortable with it, but it's the first time he's worn it, so I hope it'll give him the protection that he needs.
Riewoldt and Milne were dangerous against you last time. Who's likely to get the job on Riewoldt?
Ferguson, Bizzell, those types, Whelan, Brown, depending on where they play.
All right, thanks. Good luck.
There's Neil Danaher. I wonder how he'll enjoy this afternoon. It depends a lot on how these blokes go. They've gone with Jolly in the forward line. Well, he's certainly starting in the 18 anyway.
Yeah, so it's really going to stretch the St Kilda defence. And, of course, David Neates, a key player in this Melbourne side, as we say most weeks, with Max Hutchinson back in the side for the Saints this afternoon. And he's got a big job on the Melbourne captain, who will be obviously fired up for this afternoon's match.
Yeah, Hutchinson only conceded 8 goals in 8 matches. Across the half forwards, Green's been dangerous in previous times.
He kicked 4 2 weeks ago, and Cameron Bruce is also a very good player, and I expect him to play up forward this afternoon. And James McDonald also been in fantastic form.
Great to see Kaczynski back too. Now, the big question is going to be, who's going to go to Hayes, who's going to go to Harvey?
Well, I think Godfrey and Leoncelli will get the run with roles. Probably Godfrey on Hayes and Leoncelli on Harvey, but it's just such a critical matchup, particularly for Melbourne, because if they can curb Hayes and Harvey, they'll go a long way towards winning the match.
And we heard Neil Danaher there, Riewoldt's going to be a big danger.
Yes, and I think Ferguson will get the job. He'll start with the height advantage that he's got in the Melbourne defence, and he's got a key role to play this afternoon.
And at full forward, Gehrig's been kicking goals, and do you think Whelan will get the job on Milne?
Yes, definitely. I think Matthew Whelan is a tigerish player, but he'll need to be at his best to curb Stephen Milne. Has kicked 22 goals in 10 matches this year and has ruled live wire up forward for the Saints.
Yeah, he's just slowed up a bit, hasn't he, in the last few weeks, so he'll be looking for a big one today. In the ruck, White versus Noble. Great to see both of them back, particularly Noble.
Oh, well, remarkable recovery, really, from ruptured vertebrae in the neck, and it's great to see Trent Noble back. A big challenge for him this afternoon up against Jeff White, who really is the key player in this Melbourne side.
And Robert Harvey, obviously, in great form as well. They're the benches, as they will start Heffernan and Armstrong, Thompson and Miller, and for the Saints, Peckett, Thompson, Goddard and Maguire. And there are the lineups for today's match, and the Saints are already out on the ground and they're practicing down at the Punt Road end of the ground.
Well, it's such a critical game for them, as we mentioned. 6-6, they really need to get to the positive side of the ledger. There's one player back in the side this afternoon, Andrew Thompson. Hutchinson, Noble and Skoczynski back in, and it really does give them some more depth and also some more experience back into their side.
Well, Melbourne haven't had a lot of trouble getting the ball inside 50. In fact, they're fifth in the league in rankings, but once it's got there, the problems have started.
Well, it's unbelievable. They rank last, 16th in scoring inside 50, goals inside 50, and goal kickers per game. So it's a real area that I'm sure Neil Danaher is focused on. And I think it's more to do with the ball coming in. They need to get it in quickly and directly. And I think that's going to be the key for them this afternoon.
Going to be interesting this afternoon to watch Stephen Powell playing against his old side. He's played for the Bulldogs, Melbourne and now St Kilda. Got a remarkable record. He's won just over 60% of games that he's played in. And you consider those sides over the years in recent times haven't had the greatest of success. But success has followed Stephen Powell. I wonder if it will this afternoon when he takes on one of his old sides. Bit of blue sky and some clouds around in Melbourne on this winter's day. A great afternoon to be at the footy and watch Melbourne take on St Kilda. We're certainly looking forward to the game this afternoon. And alongside me in commentary, along with Michael Christian today, Peter Dacos. Great to see you again, Dax.
Anthony, thanks.
Who do you fancy?
It is great to be here. Well, look, certainly the Saints coming in after the bye. They've had a great first half into the season. I suppose the Demons, led by David Neates this afternoon, certainly underachieved, but have a chance to make amends. It's all about character today for them.
Yes, huge pressure on David Neates. Let's get down to Christy on the boundary line. Good afternoon, Christy.
Good afternoon. I think both teams will be very happy with the conditions here today. The rain has stayed away. In fact, they're not forecasting it until later on tonight, although rain from during the week has made the ground a little bit slippery, so it may take a little while to adjust at the beginning of the game. The wind has only just started to pick up now, not really favouring any end, just a little bit swirly, but apart from that, very good conditions.
So, how will the Demons respond? There's Jolly
Just hope they don't go too negative out of the middle. David Neitz heading to the goal square, as expected.
And Riewoldt has been picked up by Bizzle. So an interesting initial matchup, and certainly giving away plenty of height, Clint Bizzle.
Jeff White starting at centre-half forward. Jolly in the rack.
Just so important, Jeff White. And his game, the way he goes about it today.
And the big surprise, Kaczynski starting off at full forward. And he's matched up by Ryan Ferguson. So an interesting move at the outset. Riewoldt and Kaczynski up forward.
So the players, the fans, they've had a break. They're ready for action again. And this round 13 match from the MCG is underway. And Noble back in the thick of things straight away with Jolly. Lee and Shelley trying to thrust it forward. And already numbers around the ball. Such a familiar sight in AFL footy at the moment. Look at all the numbers around. And I guess that leaves space out elsewhere. But gee, some interesting matchups you talked about, Michael.
Yes, certainly. Kaczynski is really going to stretch the Melbourne defence. And at the other end, Melbourne are trying to do the same thing, stretch the St Kilda defence.
Noble got hands on that one. Riewoldt. There's Black. He's been in pretty good form after that much publicised clash with Nick Riewoldt. And then the week in the VFL, he's come back pretty strongly, Heath Black. Already some work being done in the Melbourne defence, Melbourne interchange bench, which is not a great sign. Ball yet to get out of the centre square. Jolly trying to do that for the Demons. Again, Leoncelli. Godfrey, they got a handball out. Here's Jeff White already working back into defence to help out. It may have been a high tackle. Harvey was the tackler. The umpire blowing the whistle will get another bounce.
Decision making and certainly option selection for the Demons this year in their game plan has certainly let them down. Just hoping today they can certainly find something. Interesting, Xavier Clark for the Saints also pushed up the ground, started earlier in the season playing cross halfback.
Here's Nathan Brown back in the team today. Oh, Jeff White set him up. Play on was the call. White went in to make amends. Got it out in the direction of Boston Robertson. Here's Travis Johnston. Team and fans will be hoping he can rediscover his form. Lee and Shelley pushing for him. On the bounce, the fumble was from Clark. And it lets Ward in. Gets them in, and here's Robertson. He's away and takes the mark. So the stretching of both defences on display already, with Robertson initially being matched up there by Brett Voss.
Yes, Robertson is a real key player in this Melbourne side. He's one of number Green, of course, Neitz, who really need to stand up this afternoon, take some marks inside 50, and a great chance for a good start to the Melbourne side.
Lawrence is on the mark, but here's the kick from Robertson. It just didn't quite do enough. She tried hard, but only behind. So the Demons start with the first point of the day.
And that was probably our stat prior to the game starting. Just Melbourne, their efficiency inside 50. Powell on Ozzie Jones, who tends to kick out with a short kick, then follows it up. It's a good kick, and pinpoints Black. So the Saints just forward of half, back into half forward, Riewoldt. It'll bounce just over the line. Big ask of Clint Bizzle this afternoon to follow this guy around. Riewoldt, terrific season so far.
And two great matchups in the midfield, as we talked in the preview. Leoncelli, Hayes, that'll be a great matchup. And Harvey and Godfrey.
So Noble and White, Riewoldt's there. Thumps it down, Ozzie Jones keeps it in. Great kick, left foot, and Milne couldn't mark it. Wheel and gives him a go. Slaps it back, still inside 50. Lenny Hayes going nowhere, and we will get a ball up just inside 50. No room at the moment for the players.
And Lenny Hayes, what a season he's had, not only in terms of possessions, but leading tackler for St Kilda with 60 tackles, the next best at 36.
So Noble away from goal. Schwartz to the goal square in front. Kaczynski's got it, and there was two Melbourne players there, front position. And he will go back from virtually the goal square for the first goal of the game.
Yes, and a great lesson there. Kaczynski just playing in front. The quick kick came in, and he was able just to shoulder it. Two Melbourne players to beat there. Jolly would have been perhaps a little disappointed with that effort, but just propping back and taking a very good mark.
So, first goal to the Saints as they start the second half of the year's campaign. Kaczynski with his first goal, and he will certainly prove a handful if that's anything to go by. Great pressure mark against two Demons.
Yes, and one of the great assets that St Kilda have, particularly with their young players, is their flexibility, because you can play in the ruck, play out forward or in defence, and Thomas has elected him to start him at full forward, and he's going to prove a real headache for the Melbourne defence.
Very disappointing start for Melbourne. Saints kicking the first goal. And great to see Justin Kaczynski back in the side. Noble also returned today. Godfrey trying to farm it away, but Harvey with his first touch, and now Powell. And the Saints are away again. Murray up to accept it and get it quickly into Clark at centre half forward. Good late spoil from Jeff White. Godfrey has a fervour for the footy, and his handball over the top was pretty good to Walsh in the end. McDonald can link up with White. He needs to be able to convert. Jeff White, big kick for the Demons, and he does the job. Would have really been a blow to the guts if he had missed that one.
No, it was a great finish, and Melbourne using, it's very interesting the way they're using their big men at the moment. Jolly in the centre, contesting the centre bounce down. And Jeff White starting off at centre half forward, but roaming as far as half back to try and get kicks and also just to try and link the play up. And that occasion he was able to get back into the midfield and then run through centre half forward and kick a very good goal.
Yeah, we saw Jolly playing that extra man in defence, didn't we, before. So I wonder whether White will be able to continue to do that role all day.
Well, it's a big job for Troy Schwartz.
So back in the middle, just to square it up, Jeff White with a goal. Through the middle, Schwartz, surrounded by players, and we will get a ball up again. And if there is an Achilles heel for the Saints, certainly it's in the big man department, so Neil Danaher's probably pinpointed that an area that Demons can certainly outshine him. It'll come down. Ward at goal, has a little bit of room, has he a left foot? Onto that right, he'll keep it low and kick a goal. The Demons have another. So Daniel Ward comes up with a goal, and that's two out of midfield for the Demons. Good signs early after St Kilda had kicked the first goal in the game.
Well, Daniel Ward's one of those players that is such an important part of this Melbourne side. Back in it this afternoon, and he'll be wrapped to get an early touch. And very clever, didn't bother about using his left side, just dribbling it through with the right boot. And a great start to Melbourne. They need to get away to a good start if they're going to be successful today.
Terrific start then from the Demons after that opening goal to St Kilda. Ward's second goal of the season gives them the lead. Extends it out to seven, in fact. And Godfrey, hasn't he been generating things for them out of the middle? Powell against his old team. Here's Bizzle with a shock of dark black hair, combining with Brown. Oh, over to Uze. Rewald in hot pursuit. No reward for the tackle. In fact, he's been penalised for the tackle. Held on too long after Uze, well, disposed of it of sorts.
Could have been a little bit too high on the first instance as well, Hutto.
Well, it was called holding the man, and the Kilda fans be happy with the result of that. Uze's kick really let himself down.
Well, two poor disposal errors there. One to Uze, kicking it out on the full, but moments early, and Nathan Brown, under no pressure, just missed a simple handball.
So Brett Voss looking for Noble. He got in front. Jolly able to spoil that time. And the ball over and out.
Uze is just one of three players I've pinpointed that really do need to lift. Such a very good player. So important, this team, Adam Uze. He's had a down year. And even Travis Johnson, inconsistency. And Cameron Bruce is the other player. All three have to find something.
McDonald's been one of their best this year. Onto the wing. Baker versus Lee and Shelley. Johnston looks like he's got a bit more spring in the step this afternoon. Johnston gives Neeks the chance. Wouldn't he deal? He's got to get a free. Wouldn't he deal enough to start with a goal? And now he gets the perfect opportunity.
Well, if you're a player playing at the feet of Neeks, the ball does tend to hit the ground a little bit, Chris. And even on that occasion, even though he got a free kick, there were no Melbourne players in the area, and they do have to get at his feet.
Well, there's a good look at Hutchton. Definitely had hold of Neitz's Guernsey, and obviously over the last couple of weeks Melbourne have been a little bit concerned about the attention that David Neitz is receiving, the lack of free kicks.
Yes, seven free kicks for 24 against going into today. Here he is, David Neitz, getting back to what he does best, kicking goals.
Well, I think one of the things that Melbourne have already showed early in the early part of this match is their willingness to kick the ball quickly into that attacking 50 and Johnston there getting the handball to Robertson and being direct and long, and Neats really one out inside attacking 50, and Hudson under all sorts of pressure. And a very good finish from David Neats. A great start to Melbourne.
Demons lead by 13. They've had four inside 50s to one so far.
Open forward line too, Hutto, so some good signs. Out of the middle, not this time. Goddard off to Harvey, to Black. Out wide with their possession at the moment. Out in front of Riewoldt. Bizzell in pursuit. Boundary, Bizzell's best mate. Riewoldt did well to keep it in. Nathan Brown, a little bit of time to backpedal. He's gone. Great tackle, good pressure. And it was Stevie Powell down there for the Saints. So boundary throw in, it's inside 50.
Michael, I know it's only very early, but Lenny Hayes, who's averaged 28 possessions a game, yet to touch it after 10 minutes.
Yes, it's someone that St Kilda need firing in the midfield.
So Noble, it'll go to White. Possibly Melbourne's best at the moment. Uze just lurking in behind players and will play a role, probably inside 50 defence that is. Across the ground, Milne, can he keep it in? Travis Johnson pushed him in the side, did well, was it out? Johnson, Uze, evaded two, bombs in, shocking kick, and Lenny Hayes will pick him off.
It's two poor disposal errors from Adam Uze, who's normally exquisite with his skills.
So Lenny Hayes gets a touch, up towards full forward, White, and now Whelan, out to Ward, Demons can run. Problem with Darren Jolly, who's come from the ground, he's a bit crook. We'll get to that with Christie in a moment. Here's Bizzell out to the wing. McDonald trying to track it down. Hayes in pursuit. Up to 50. Good kick for Miller, who's just on the ground. Miller had time to seize up the options. Well, he did seize up instead of sizing it up because he's kicked it out of bounds. Or, in fact, it's through from behind.
And Brad Miller coming on the ground, as you mentioned, Hutto, and just was able to sneak inside attacking 50 as we look at the injury to Jolly, getting a knee right in the midriff.
Just watching Noble behind play. He's trying to sit with White in defence, in Melbourne's defence. They have Riewoldt there as well, which really St Kilda lack a tall man if it's in any other part of the ground to contest. So it's a ground level. Vice, little left footer, not really directing it. Use of the body. Bizzell behind it, over the top. Demons again, very good out of defence. Good use of the ball. Miller turns around and loads up. Just forward of wing. Bangs it in long. Neats against two. Schwartz did beautifully to back up Hutchton. Hutchton evades one. Green in there. Black pressing. Has got it now. Saints out of danger. They need to use it. Lenny Hayes into the air. No one there. White sits back. It's three against one. Noble big ask. Jeff White again does it beautifully. Has to use it and does. And Miller getting some early touches.
Yeah, it's amazing how circumstances can create opportunities, isn't it? Miller making the most of it at the moment. McDonald's kick not great. Lawrence meets in over the top. And then we'll get down to Christie for an update on Jolly.
Well, Darren Jolly, the good news is that he's sitting back with the rest of the players. He's been assessed by the doctors. He did receive a heavy knock in the stomach. Was sick on the ground before he came off, but it looks like he was just heavily winded and is okay.
So lots of numbers around the ball. The Demons into attack. Walsh made it a little difficult for Neats. I guess it was a haphazard kick, G. Neats. He demanded the footy, and then he could have got a free kick. He will. Umpire initially paid the advantage. Now he's going to bring it back. And this is where the rule gets very murky indeed, because if the umpire decided that Robertson had the advantage and then he misses, I don't think he can bring it back. If he decides that he didn't have the advantage, then fair enough, bring it back.
Well, it's about determining if there is an advantage. And perhaps Melbourne a touch lucky, but if the umpire deems that it really wasn't any advantage and Robertson was under pressure, then they're well within their rights to bring it back. But David Neats, interestingly enough, takes two free kicks in the early part of the match.
Well, the other thing is I like him flying, running with the flight of the football. Certainly makes it harder for the defender to bring the ball to the ground.
He showed it then, didn't he? Just his brute strength. And now it comes down to conversion again. Makes great contact. What a start for David Neats. Two goals from the Melbourne skipper, 4-2-26. St Kilda one straight six, 20 points the difference.
Well, it's just the start that Melbourne needed. They've obviously been down on a lot of confidence. As we look at the free kick to David Neats, it was certainly there. And I wonder whether he would have been paid those free kicks a couple of weeks ago. But two free kicks and two goals, and he's given his side a fantastic opening to this match and a big chance.
Fabulous start to the Demons. And hopefully this will give him a little bit of confidence. It'll come down. Lenny Hayes has just crashed into great physical strength from the Demons. They go into attack again. Miller will, that's Cameron Bruce, I should say, at goal, and will miss everything. But the signs are good. Lenny Hayes in a lot of trouble. And good afternoon, says Clint Bizzle.
Surely that's going to be a free kick, Dave.
Well, it should have been.
It should have been a free kick.
And they've been prone to let play go in recent weeks, the umpires. Ozzie Jones will just bob it up, and pretty slow moving it in, so it allows the Demons to get back into defence. Powell over the top, Maguire for the Saints.
That's one thing they've done very well early, Melbourne, getting numbers back inside defensive 50 to really counter any chance the St Kilda forwards have.
Oh, that's a great kick, and Kaczynski comes out to accommodate it. So centre half forward, hands off, played on. Will hand off now, a little bit of room. Black should bang it at goal from 40. He does, and he will finish with a goal. So just what the Saints were looking for against the run of play, but the Saints have their second goal.
Well, they worked it out pretty well then, St Kilda. Kaczynski was outnumbered at the top of the goal square. Melbourne had three extra numbers back, and sensing that, he was able to lead up the ground, take the mark, and perhaps a little lucky to get away with it, but a great finish from Black. And St Kilda, as Dave said, against the run of play, a very important goal to keep in this match.
And great news, Lenny Hayes is okay. He's just shrugged off the bump and back to his feet and involved. The Saints, an important one, 14 points the margin. Bruce with a releasing kick for the Demons. Up to half forward, McDonald back onto Baker. Shrug of the shoulders, and he's okay and away, and the Saints are lining up and they can carry it. No better man to carry it than Robert Harvey. His delivery wasn't great, but it turned out to be perfect, if that makes sense. And Riewoldt on the end of it.
Well, there was Thompson in the area on that wing position after it came off half-back from Stephen Baker. Harvey, and the other one was Nathan Burke, and a lot of the Melbourne players were still in the middle of the ground.
So here's Nick Riewoldt from just outside 50. He's kicked 16 goals, 11 for the year, and had two misses completely. And you can make that 16 goals, 12 now. As the Saints go to 2-1, 13, and Melbourne 4-2, 26. St Kilda have kicked less goals than any other team from outside 50 this year.
They certainly do look exciting, though, when they go forward, the Saints. And with Riewoldt and Kaczynski up there, providing a target along with Fraser Gehrig,
great shot,
certainly
from
looks
behind.
Dangerous.
Sorry, Michael, great shot from behind the goals there, Dutch. Yeah, you feel great. Like you're kicking the ball out with him.
Well, here we go.
Almost.
We put the moss on him. So Uze out wide. What a great kick. Bizzle does enough, and the ball will be thrown in. Bizzle just keeping Riewoldt under the ball. Important, his role today. So handball's 21-8. Use of the ball at the moment. Pretty good for the Demons. Not overusing it. Certainly putting it to their advantage, as the scoreboard suggests. It comes down. Johnson, Riewoldt. Toe-poking Lee and Charlie. Wrong way. Lenny Hayes. It's inside 50. Back to the square. Gehrig. The sit. No, can't mark it. We'll go back in. Fraser Gehrig through his legs against two Nicholson. Milne. Danger now, as he is wrapped up in the end. Whelan it was. And it will be a free against Stevie Milne and Matty Whelan to take it. So Johnson just holding on to the football at the moment. No great rush. McDonald will come up, and that's where he goes. A shocking kick. He was looking for McDonald. It was touched off the man in the mark. Ozzie Jones pushed, and that ball ends up on the full.
Unlucky not to get a free kick there, Ozzie Jones. He was pushed right in the middle of the back as he was taking that kick.
So Johnston goes searching for Bruce. Got to come at Riewoldt, though, and he couldn't.
We've got to try and keep that ball away from Riewoldt.
Into Swartz. Has been following the big man down from defence. And he's, look at all the numbers back for Melbourne. Plenty, not much space for Gehrig to work in. Kaczynski down there as well, has to go wide to Riewoldt. No better position really, but he can link up over the top. Hayes doesn't want to have a shot from there. Instead, he pinpoints Gehrig. Well worked by the Saints. Gehrig took a long time to have his shot. A long time. But he's done the job. He's kicked the goal. Now, that's pretty well worked by the Saints in the end.
They thought their way through that very, very well. There's one thing that can happen. If you play on, you tend to create opportunities, and that's exactly what Riewoldt did with the handball over to Hayes, and Gehrig was able to get into a position and receive the football. Gee, he was lucky to convert, because he delayed the kick for a couple of extra steps and perhaps he would have liked, but in the end, a good goal to St Kilda.
So the Saints, thanks to Fraser Gehrig, have got it back to 7 points. The Demons, last two occasions trying to get out of defence, Saints have done well just to hold it inside 50. Leon Challey racked up by Thompson. And we will go again.
Hayes starting to find it too. 4 possessions for Lenny Hayes.
Just so important to the Saints. Very creative, Lenny Hayes. And he's running forward of the football or inside 50. So if he becomes a scorer, invaluable. We will go again with a ball up. Lenny Hayes on screen. Terrific year. Andrew Thompson back in the team today. And there is just a mass of players around this football. Makes it pretty hard going. Ball's bounce. Free kick again. This time going to the Saints.
Their first free kick, 5 to Melbourne.
Maguire onto Ozzie Jones. Not a bad kick. It'll bounce. Gehrig leads Nicholson. Nicholson, the ball just bounced back and allowed him to get a fist to it. It's over the line, so it's outside 50 to be thrown in.
One thing Grant Thomas will be very happy about is the contest that Matt Maguire provides. He really does go hard at the football. And then we look at the player rankings. Jeff White, the standout, along with the Melbourne captain, David Neitz.
And there is Jeff White. He really has had an impact on the game so far. Leon Shelley trying to do something for the Demons, who have just slowed down a fraction, mainly due to the play of the Saints, who have kicked the last couple. They're 3-1-19. Melbourne 4-2-26. Again, enormous numbers around the contest, making it difficult to win a clean possession. White was colourblind, went to Thompson, and now Harvey had to delay the kick because there was nowhere to go. Goddard gets a bit of pace up. Gehrig, a chance from the back. But Ferguson combining with Nicholson. And again, a behind on the board. So the Saints 3-2-20, the Demons 4-2-26. We've gone 22 minutes in the opening quarter from the MCG. And again, you can see the task ahead of Adam Uzay.
Well, let's see if the Demons are able to work this one out. Again into the pocket, numbers side. Matty Whelan to take it.
St Kilda just happy to concede that kick into the pocket and then get numbers across to the relevant side of the ground. And now Whelan faced with really not much to go to at all.
So the ball will end up in the air, as it does. Riewoldt front position, Bizzle pushing in, and Riewoldt will mark. So Nick Riewoldt's positioning is good. Into the middle of the ground. Kaczynski dives in, will take it. Did beautifully for a big man. Bangs it in. Powell's got it. Stevie Powell has marked about 25 from goal. And he was just lurking. And again, the Demons having problems getting that ball out of defence.
Well, they certainly are. As I say, St Kilda happy to concede the initial kick into the pocket. And Melbourne really then confronted with a problem. And with the marking strength of St Kilda, particularly Nick Riewoldt, they're able to work it out pretty quickly. And a good opportunity here for Stephen Powell.
So Powell at goal, not a problem. Not a problem. And scores are tied up. It's 4-2 apiece. Powell has his first goal.
Well, Melbourne made a great start to this match. They led by 20 points at the 14-minute mark, but the Saints have kicked the last 3 goals and have really looked very dangerous. And it's a great trap there by Kaczynski, and just getting the ball in quickly. And a couple of options there, Gehrig and also Powell. In fact, if Powell hadn't have taken, I'm sure Fraser Gehrig would have. So St Kilda have hit back hard, and Melbourne now just need to consolidate until quarter time, maybe kick a goal or two.
Stephen Powell and James McDonald waiting for the umpire to put it back into the turf. White and Maguire squaring off in the centre. A low bounce that favoured Maguire, who got there first. Thompson read it beautifully, and they're starting to link up nicely out of the middle. The space opens up for Goddard. He saw Burke, who desperately lunges to get there. Always had Ozzie Jones in support. Got there on the second effort. Left foot from Jones, not a great kick. And Jolly, who's recovered, takes the mark and links up with Ward. And now Brown, who better watch out, had to kick quickly and had to kick well to centre-half forward, but couldn't. Voss with the spoil, gets help from Goddard. Plenty of Saints all around. Heath Black on the end of it, switches for Maguire as they come to the members' side. Gehrig makes his lead, then he doubles back. He had Milne away to the left. Had to go shorter for Burke. Gehrig still back in the square, being watched by Nicholson. He's ready to make his lead. He comes at him now and then has to double back. Demon zoning off and forcing Burke to switch to Jones. Kaczynski could be the target here. Oh, they'll line up. Lawrence, as he loves to do, floating down from defence, and Kaczynski just cleared the path for him beautifully.
Great turnover by St Kilda, and Brendan Goddard has been a star since coming onto the ground. He had just got great composure for a young player who was tackled, but just kept his arms free and was able to set this St Kilda attack up.
They set it up beautifully because Jolly was lurking loose, so they were very patient.
Can play either end, Stephen Lawrence. He's kicked 7 goals for the year. That won't add to his total. Milne can't keep it in. And I guess not the most penetrating of kicks, Stephen Lawrence. And we know that all the sides have had trouble at that end of the ground this year, kicking goals. Saints on level terms with the Demons, though, as we get towards quarter time at the MCG. Good grunt work provided by Whelan. And now, Huse can let fly. His fifth possession, his fifth kick to Green. He's been a wonderful player for the Demons in previous matches against the Saints. Hasn't seen much of it today. Neitz was competitive, but so was Baker. Outsized, but not outpointed, and was able to switch. And this is what they've been able to do very well in the last 15 minutes or so. Jones, Burke, some old names combining. Milne out on the full. Frustration's just starting to show a little bit with Stephen Milne.
Yes, but great spoil at the other end by Brett Voss. David Neitz was all over that football, but Voss left his man, committed his body, and effected a very good spoil.
So Johnson supplying. White dropped it. Black, Harvey, good use of the ball. Burke through the traffic to Hayes. Missed Goddard in the end. But right in front of the members, half forward, boundary throw-in. Saints have been very good. Hayes starting to come in. Harvey. They are starting to win the football, and when they do, look out.
Ozzie Jones, 9 possessions as well, Dakes. He's been the number one on the ground.
Another key, Hutto. So White, just off balance. Maguire did well. Black, hands clear to Hayes, over the top, trying to find Thompson. Uzay off the ground, danger. Gehrig, ball. Chance with a player in support. He allowed Milne to go at goal. No chance of a handball. Rewalt, no, couldn't take it. Under pressure, at the feet of Rewalt, out wide, Powell for his second, yes sir. No, sir. From behind. Been a long time, Hutto.
Gee, it was great slick hands from Nick Rewalt, close in to Powell, very effective, and Stephen Powell just a fraction unlucky not to finish off there with a goal for St Kilda.
Hands have been fantastic from the Saints, under pressure, working it into a play with a little bit of time.
And here at Melbourne go again, just struggling to get out of their defensive 50 from a behind.
It's been a common theme, hasn't it, for the teams that have struggled this year when opponents can man up. Oh, was he off? Gee, Travis Johnson, very laconic about the way he moved after taking the mark. He's always very laconic in appearance, Travis Johnston.
One of the problems at the moment, a lot of their midfield players getting touches in defence. They have to start working hard and forward to the football.
Boy, did he set a tough task for Jolly, who had to beat 2. Goddard had plenty of support. Hayes starting to really find it now. Possession number 6. Jones in the double figures. Goddard had to hesitate. Andrew Thompson blasts it long into the square. Kaczynski made a late bid. Ferguson, everywhere he looked, he saw some Kilda Guernseys until Bizzle and now Johnston came along to save the day. Nothing to go there for Travis Johnston. Wants to go down the middle. Needs a forward to lead. Needs someone to demand it. Green does. Takes a wonderful grab. 70 from goal. Meets Walsh back there. They say, just get it in quickly. They're screaming to kick it. Green hesitating.
Too slow.
Now he gets a man away. It's Robertson. But the angle will be tight for Russell Robertson and the task very difficult.
Yes, so it was a good kick in the air, but David Neates led three times to try and get the kick from Brad Green. And
Why do you think he didn't pass?
Well,
he
just didn't I don't
think
know.
It was a good enough option?
Well, he was a couple of metres in front of Hudson. I don't know, because that certainly would have been the better option, because Robertson will kick from close to the boundary line. Neates would have been directly in front.
Kicked 22 goals for the year, Russell Robertson. And that will not be another one. He started the day with two behinds. He's kicked 22-18 for the year. There's Brett Green.
And one of the problems Melbourne have got, they're getting numbers back inside their defensive 50, but when they get the football back there, there's no one in the midfield because all their numbers are back. So Travis Johnston did the right thing there, ran through the half-back line and tried to be direct.
Jones directed to Maguire.
Good mark.
Right mark, Johnston. Not played in the end. Burke chips up. Brown front position in the end. Burke will go on again. Powell allowed him to do that. Black through the traffic. Lenny Hayes. Plenty of time, will draw, and could be danger now. He could go long, has options. Kaczynski's a player he heads for. He'll jump. He had it. No, he didn't, as the siren goes. And pretty good first quarter of action. First goal to that guy, Kaczynski. And then the Demons banged on four, and St Kilda were able to work their way back into the game.
So who's on top at the end, Michael?
Scores a level, Hutter. But a great start by Melbourne. They really came out of the blocks, and it's what they needed to do. David Neates kicked a couple of early goals, and they really had some momentum up. But to St Kilda's credit, they were able to hit back, just gain some control in the midfield with Harvey and Hayes getting it. Didn't touch the ball early, but he really got into the game. Ozzie Jones also going extremely well, and to hit back the way they did, the sign of a good side.
That's the way you want to work, Michael, and that's the way it'll be for the rest of the day. Plenty to think about for Grant Thomas. 4-3-27 St Kilda, 4-3-27 Melbourne. We're back at the MCG shortly.
Pinpointed that an area that Demons can certainly outshine them. It'll come down. Ward at goal, has a little bit of room. Has he a left foot? Onto that right, he'll keep it low and kick a goal. The Demons have another.
Yes, they got four, in fact, in the opening quarter. It looked very good. David Neates leading the way with two goals. But then the Saints hit back. And at quarter time, 4-3-27 apiece. Nick Riewoldt certainly looking dangerous. Taken six marks in the opening term so far. So Riewoldt and Kaczynski both playing very well up forward for the Saints. Second quarter about to get underway. Michael, David Neates, all the pressure, of course, and he hasn't been in great goal-kicking form the last 3 weeks, but he's come in today with a couple of goals.
Yes, he started with two goals. Interestingly enough, they were from free kicks, but he was able to finish well. And one thing, I've been watching him very closely. He's leading very hard, presenting all the time. And if Melbourne can just get the ball in quickly to him, he'll give them every possible chance.
And at the other end of the ground, of course, Riewoldt we mentioned, and Justin Kaczynski. Great to see him back. He's had two marks and kicked one goal.
Yes, named at centre-half back, but lining up at full forward. So you've got Riewoldt, Kaczynski and Gehrig all up forward. And it's a very good mark. He held out two Melbourne players to take that mark and kick the goal. And it's one of the young guns in the St Kilda side who they'll look for to really make a big impression over the next couple of years.
And Michael, you wanted to speak about Xavier Clark, who we saw at quarter time. We're getting some words from Grant Thomas.
Yes, Grant Thomas just took Xavier Clark to the side of the huddle here. You can't quite see from that shot, but he had his arm firmly around his waist, just making a few points, but also some positive reinforcement, I'm sure, to one of his young players who he certainly recognises over the next two or three years as the future of St Kilda.
Xavier Clark yet to have a touch. Second quarter about to get underway. Both sides level, and a very important term for Melbourne and St Kilda. As Saturday afternoon footy from the MCG continues, and the Saints it'll be with first use out of the middle. Burke pumping it in long. Kaczynski and Riewoldt. Bizzle took a chance, and in the end it was Ferguson that marked, but Bizzle certainly helped him, easing the ball across halfback, using Jeff White on the way out. The Demons hoping they can come out with the same fervour they had in the first quarter. Oh, Brown in his full measure. Now Bruce wanted to give it back, but Brown wasn't quite aware and ready. Demons going wide, but at least controlling the footy. Here's Robertson. Neates down there, making his lead. just got the yard on Hudson, so he's been able to get away several times.
Just watching the Demons, Clint Bizzle is running forward and trying to get inside 50. Doesn't need to do that because what he's doing is actually dragging in Riewoldt as well, which again is clogging up a lot of the, if any, space inside 50 for the Dews.
Again, space at a premium in the Melbourne forward line. Neitz takes a chance. Good centre and kick. He spotted Uze. Just couldn't handle it cleanly. Doesn't quite seem to be himself this afternoon. And the Saints through Harvey get out of trouble. Riewoldt had to beat a desperate Bizzle there. Did well, Clint Bizzle in the end. Kept it going. Walsh controlling it. Nathan Brown. Time to steady up and just get the right foot to the lunging Green. Green takes the mark. Can line up for goals. We go down to Christy Malthouse.
Well, Darren Jolly has started on the bench. He is okay, though. We saw him run out the rest of that term in the first quarter, so he is okay, but starting on the bench for now. The other player to look for is Jeff White. He's wearing a new shin guard on his right leg to protect his shins from splishing and bleeding. He has had trouble with that, but he's had a guard specially made for him today, and he's wearing it today, so just watch out for him.
Seems to be working well so far for Jeff White with 9 possessions, but all eyes on Brad Green, who wobbles it towards goal. Didn't look pretty, but the result was great. Melbourne back in front at the MCG, 5-3-33. St Kilda 4-3-27, the margin 6.
Well, they've done pretty well, Melbourne, the opening couple of minutes of their second quarter. Just been very desperate. They've kept the ball inside their attacking half, and a good finish by Brad Green. Just what they needed after St Kilda kicked the last 3 goals of the first quarter. They need to kick that goal at the opening of the second quarter just to try and give them some momentum.
So the Demons back in front. 4 lead changes in total so far in the game. Some good signs. Good contest. Heffernan through the traffic, left it behind. Powell and Walsh come together. Heffernan, Noble, Johnson out of the middle, inside 50 for the Dees. Well done, Robertson. And it'll be a free to Voss. So out wide quickly and plenty of room. Lenny Hayes again, just too much space. Will take a bounce. Neitz has come a long way chasing him off screen. He bangs inside 50, Geary. Good use, Nicholson. It'll come down. They need to mop up. Thompson over the top. Demons head back to the boundary. Johnson says no, back into the corridor. Good kick, Bruce. Has to be good, is, and we'll take it in the end. So Cameron Bruce and the Demons ready to move forward. Out wide to Ferguson. Chance to go into the corridor. He'll bang inside 50, drop short, McDonald. So pretty effective at the moment, Demons. Not pretty football. But the next possession, so important. Needs a target. It's into the pocket. Green. Players will jump. It'll come down. Chance for the Demons. In and out of the traffic. Walsh, no left foot. On that right, around the body. And does it scrape in? It does. So minor score. Scoring, all the scoring at the moment with the Demons. 34-27. And Ozzie Jones with the ball.
He's had this role for most of the season for the Saints.
He tends to go short and then try and follow it up. They try and use his running out of defence.
Baker. Again, Melbourne have been able to man up most of the St Kilda players. The one free man is Swartz. He spots him. Robertson tried to work hard. Get back and help out. Voss and Harvey, and now Noble. In plenty of space. Didn't get a kind bounce at all. Takes an eternity to pick it up, but he always knew he had Hayes running past to help, and in the end, Peckett, who's just been inserted into the game. Gee, the Saints made a meal of that one. Whelan, aggressive, good play by the Demons. More decisive, Heffernan off the left, the half-forward Voss out, pointed by Bruce, Mark Payne. In fact, it's Miller, who's taken 5 marks, I think, now for the day. 4 marks, Brad Miller. Centering kick was okay. Heffernan off a couple of steps, puts it out in front of Green, got bullied out of it by Lawrence, into David Neitz, into the square, oh, and all the way! No touched! Oh, the man in the sunglasses, just the one finger up. 5-4-34 Melbourne, St Kilda 4-3-27.
And the turnover caused there because Lenny Hayes didn't provide a shepherd on the wing just to allow Peckett to break free.
So Lenny Hayes up into the air. Brad Miller got a hand to it, ran with a flight and then let it go. Loose ball, Peckett has to be good. Players going, Demons have been excellent in this area. Physical, very physical. Black into the middle, Rewalt. Rewalt to load up, inside 50. That's a good kick, Gehrig. Oh, dropped it, took it far too easy, had it spent. And in the end, trying to play for the free. It's outside St Kilda's 50. Well done, Demons. Johnson, out of danger. Walsh, so they'll turn it into attack. He'll try and draw. Has a player in support. That man is Nathan Brown. Effective kick, Green. So Brad Green with an early goal to start this second quarter. And the game again swung in Melbourne's favour. Has to be good. Danger if they lose it. Goddard, well done. Rewalt there, Heffernan back in. Thompson for the Saints. Can't control it, Heffernan. Hands off in the end to Ward. Into the pocket to Neitz. Long way from goal, will take it. So just sharing it around Demons. And David Neitz looking around for another option. It'll take a mighty kick if he decides to have a ping.
He can kick it a long way, but this is a huge ask.
Like he may be loading up. David Neitz still looking and waiting, very patient.
You just see the St Kilda numbers back inside their defensive 50. There is a hole there. No so one wanting to lead into it.
Neitz may go straight to the square, and that's where he heads. It's long. It's long. Oh. And that is a great goal. What a goal. Oh. You talk skipper's goal, you put that at the top of the list. David Neitz. That is a beauty. No options. And the Demons have another.
Well, they've started the second quarter as they did the first. Melbourne kicked the opening two goals. They lead by 14 points. But the turnover caused by Fraser Gehry. And a drop mark. And then a second effort, which he'd be very disappointed in, I'm sure. A great goal to Nathan Beetz, who has three.
So Max Hudson not enjoying his return to the game. He only had 8 goals conceded going into today, but David Neitz, 3 goals, started in great style for Melbourne. Out of the middle, Saints trying to overcome a 14-point deficit. Goddard has been good, and Harvey probably hasn't had the effect that he has in other matches so far. He's had 8 possessions so far. Uze, Demons winning the important contest at the moment around the ground. Black reading it nicely, though. He can get plenty of penetration into his kicks and is able to switch play to Ozzie Jones, who's been prolific. Linking up with Thompson. Had Schwartz running with him. Oh, Rewald again in great shape to mark. Bizzle worried him out of that one. Over the top of the ball. He's in danger. Travis Johnson. Burke able to win it. Give Powell the opportunity. Could have caught one high. He did. There wasn't much of a touch on him, but perhaps
well,
just
I'll tell you what. He was very, very lucky to get that free kick because by choice he went to ground. He had his head down. And that could have easily been construed as ducking the head, and very lucky Stephen Powell to get this free kick.
Well, that's a grey area in that rule.
Well, you know, you can't.
You're trying to evade, so you have to duck to try.
Now, watch him go to ground here. He goes to ground. Well, there was certainly contact, but is it deemed that he ducked his head?
Well, looked like a fair decision to me, but anyway, you're the expert, Chriso. Here's Powell's kick. And it is powerful and direct. And the Saints needed it, and Powell provides.
Well, Stephen Powell's had an impact on this game. He's had 3 marks, 7 possessions, now kicked 2 goals. And although, as I say, I reckon a little lucky to get that free kick, a good goal to St Kilda because Melbourne had started this quarter extremely well, and they did work very hard to get back to the end of the first quarter of the Saints, and they certainly needed that goal for the boot of Stephen Powell.
So you'd see that a lot. Stephen Powell, leading scorer, goal kicker for the Saints with 2. It'll come down and work at Baker, just chips over the top. Powell, another touch, he's running forward of the ball. Has to be quick. He'll bang it in long. Gehrig sets himself. Kaczynski. Players go in. It'll come down in support. Well done, Bizzle. He'll just see it through. So all he needed to do in the end, play the percentages. and the Demons to bring it back in.
In a moment, we'll get an injury update from Christy Malthouse. There's been a bit of activity on the benches today. Ferguson can go for a stroll. He's got no immediate next target, though. He had to wait till someone presented. Whelan flew and took a great grab on the wing. Well played, Matthew Whelan. Now Travis Johnston, who really has discovered his form today. 13 possessions for Johnston. Bruce looking better as well. Pumping it in quickly to the captain. Another free. Talk about go to extremes. Only had 7 for the year and 24 against going into today. And now David Neitz has been provided with 3 free kicks and possibly 3 goals resulting from them.
And all within very close range of goal. Let's have a look at it. Well, I hope the umpires are consistent over the weekend, because historically, this season, that would not have been paid as a free kick.
So David needs to convert. And he does. 4 goals for the captain. Melbourne 7th, 7-5-47. St Kilda 5-4-34, 3 goals from free kicks for the Demons. And let's have another look at it.
There was an arm on the shoulder, but incidental.
It can't have been for that bit over the top. It had to be for the early bit, surely.
I reckon there'll be a hotline to Jeff Geachin's office making appointments to come and see the director of umpiring.
So 4 goals to David Neitz. He's having one of those days. Certainly setting the Demons up, holding his ground, playing very strong out of the middle. Peckett, Saints need one.
Oh.
Lenny Hayes did it beautifully, balanced up and bangs it in. Riewoldt nearly had it. Now about that for a free kick. So they've got the wrong umpire at that end of the ground, the Demons, or the Saints, I should say.
Dakes, let's have a look at that interference to Riewoldt and just try and draw some comparison to the free kick paid to Neitz just a few moments ago. Now, he's been held and thrust to the ground, and that is worse than the Neitz incident, in my view.
So, ball will come in. Maguire down. Hayes is in the area. Burke, it'll be a Melbourne free. And McDonald to take it. So, into the middle. White has Brown. White will load up. Short into the middle. Nicholson moving forward to the ball. So Demons with another chance. Has to be good. Goddard back there. Well done. Got his fist to the ball. Baker, Lawrence, over the top. Ozzie Jones. Pressure at the moment for the Saints to work. Try and work it into space. Black's in trouble. Evaded one, then got it to Ozzie Jones. Out of danger, St Kilda. Big ass. Murray in against, or sandwiched against, 2 players. Too high on Whelan. And that's the way it was seen. So Melbourne at the moment, winning on the scoreboard, certainly winning the favours from the umpire, certainly put themselves in though. Armstrong, a true wing, members side, no great rush. So again, Harvey back pedals, not back enough. Nicholson, chance to supply in. Well done, front position. Stevie Lawrence comes down. Riewoldt, and not able to get it clear, and we have a ball up.
Let's get to Christy on the bench for an injury update.
Trent Noble, who possibly didn't think he'd be playing today because of a neck injury, has just gone down to the Melbourne race to get a cut above his right eye stitched up. He's bleeding quite heavily.
James McDonald buried after he kicked it from Hutchison. Good work from Burke, although he's in danger here. He's over the top. He's getting a free. And the Saints fans enjoy that one. 5 free kicks to St Kilda, 8 to Melbourne today. The margin is 13. It's a mighty hard game to read at the moment. Melbourne in front. Be interested in your thoughts on just which way the game's going in a moment, Michael, as Gehrig finds Maguire on the wing. Oh, he's off, he's in trouble. Had to kick hurriedly, but kicked well in the end. Murray back on the ground, almost takes the mark, not quite. Uzay there to clean up, giving some drive off halfback, teaming up with Walsh, we've seen him in the forward line for part of the afternoon. Bruce almost out mark, but he got the lollies in the end. Streams away and misses away to the left. What are you pointing at, Dax?
Gehrig back in defence now. I think he has a job on David Neitz.
So they made the move. What do you think of that, Michael?
Well, I really don't think it was necessary. I think Hutchinson was doing a pretty good job. Three free kicks that Neitz has received. And although I think most of them have been there, there's no question about that, I thought Hutchinson generally was doing a reasonable job.
So Ozzie Jones brings it in. Over the back it'll go. Voss at his feet did well to trap it. Stevie Lawrence smothered in the end. Cameron Bruce actually coming into the game. He's been pretty good for the D's. Then gave it up. Murray through the traffic. Lawrence, Murray, hands and knees. Pushed in the end. And Thompson was there. Nathan Brown, the Demons, will run it away. Into the middle. Good kick. White's got it. So Demons with a chance. He'll turn and drew in the end. McDonald, little bit of time. Robertson is the target. That's where he goes. So the goal square, bit of a wrestle. Hutchinson gets a fist to it. It's a free to Robertson. No. Hutchinson.
A classic example there. Jeff White had an opportunity to kick straight into the attacking 50 to Neitz, and he decided to handball instead, which put all the Ford's leads out of kilter.
So Ozzie Jones back to black. Under a lot of pressure at the moment. We've seen this in Melbourne's game. About the 15-minute mark on in that first quarter where a lot of pressure coming from St Kilda. Lenny Hayes back in defence, into the air. Bizzle will fly, was pushed in the end. Did well. Chance now for the Saints. Rewalt can run. The big man will bang into half forward. Out in front of Murray, it'll bounce. Uze gave him a chance, could have just held up. Uze, too much experience in the end, gave it up. Peckett, chance now for Murray. Hugging the boundary, bangs it in long. Contest Kosciuszko, you'd back him, couldn't mark it in the end. And the Demons flood back Armstrong to rush it through minor score.
So what are your thoughts, Michael? Who's winning the war? Obviously the Demons are on the scoreboard.
Oh, look, I think that Melbourne are playing very well, but the question is, can they keep this level of intensity up for the entire game? And just get the feeling when St Kilda do move forward, they do look very dangerous.
Jeff White had to work really hard there for the Demons. He did. Oh, Ferguson straight for the boundary line. And luckily enough for him, he was able to take it over himself. Otherwise, he could have been pinged if they still remember that rule.
Just the other thing with the move of Gary back to fullback, it just takes something away from the St Kilda forward line. Melbourne were having trouble matching up on the St Kilda forwards. And certainly it makes Neil Danaher's job a little easier now that Gehrig's at fullback.
The proof of your comments about them working hard was shown by that 1%ers figure with Melbourne appreciably more, about 15 more than St Kilda. There's Noble, who's returned from the rooms.
The other thing the Demons have done is stop the run of Ozzie Jones. Just so important, St Kilda, with his chipping and his ability to run on again.
Ozzie Jones, 14 possessions. He had 10 in the first quarter. We just caught Milne on the bench. We noticed Murray's back on there. Michael Milne just only had the one touch. Just doesn't seem to be able to find the footy as much as he was.
No, he's certainly going through a quiet patch, but I'm sure he'll get another opportunity, Stephen Milne. And at his best, I mean, he is such a live wire and gives the St Kilda forward line so much bite.
Walsh, Xavier Clark's first touch of the day. Here's Heath Black trying to break clear, but he was going absolutely nowhere. Desperation shown by Clark and Jones and Powell. Maguire's got Hayes away for him. Lenny Hayes delivers to full forward and delivers beautifully. Kosciuszko, 40 metres out, slight angle, and the Saints can get one back.
St Kilda's handball was just absolutely superb there. They didn't panic. They were under pressure, but they shot the handball away. It was precise, and the kick from Hayes was a great finish to the chain of handballs. And an opportunity here just to inch closer, and as I said earlier, I just get the feeling St Kilda, when they do move forward, they look particularly dangerous.
Blood Rule wheeling off and Ward back on for the Demons. That was the delay. So Justin Kosciuszko, who started the day with a goal, has kicked 8 goals for the season going into today. He's now got 9 goals, 5 in 8 matches.
And Stephen Milne back on the ground for St Kilda as well.
So there's the task confronting Kosciuszko from the reverse angle. He looks like he's got it pretty much online. And the Saints get one they desperately needed. Well worked by St Kilda. And they stay right in touch. 6-5-41 to 7-6-48, the margin back to 7.
As we look at the chain of handballs, Powell, Maguire setting Hayes away. And it all started from some desperate play from Xavier Clark on the wing. diving on the football and was able to get it out. And Justin Kaczynski providing the Melbourne defence with plenty of headaches.
So Kaczynski with his second goal. And certainly for the Demons at those stoppages. St Kilda so good in close. You see a third man up in support of Jolly. Just looking away. It'll come down to Xavier Clark to have a ping at goal. It's into the air. It's long and just touched on the line. Ferguson did enough.
I don't know what Stephen Milne, whether he handballed or whether he just touched that, but that was absolutely superb out of the centre by Stephen Milne getting that ball away.
So Uze to bring it back. Plenty of new haircuts on display too. I guess the week off, the players had a bit more time on their hands. We saw Xavier Clark's do, and Bizzle's had the change in colour. Riewoldt still the shock of blonde hair. Got it to the front. Hayes, just finding the footy a bit more at the moment. Ozzie Jones, off the left. Swarce has floated down into attack. And his aggression was great. Ferguson, all the pressure on. Brown is cool and calm. Under pressure there, as you could possibly hope for. His kick wasn't great, though. It was to a one-on-one. And Baker,
strong,
able to grasp it. Swing in on Maguire, blindsided. Tackle from Bruce. And now Black and Goddard, and the Saints can line up on the other side of the ground. Ozzie Jones, time to steady. Time to get the hit over the ball. And sink the slipper straight through the middle. And scores a level at the MCG. As the second quarter mirrors the first, Michael.
Yes, St Kilda really getting on top in general play. And Matt Maguire was absolutely fantastic in this exchange. He was tackled, but he was able to keep his arms free. Didn't panic, got it off to Goddard, who was able to deliver to Jones. And we all know Ozzie Jones' finishing capability. And St Kilda really controlling things at the moment.
So Ozzie Jones, attacking position, finishes with a goal. And they will try and get the ball to him. Jolly down. Lenny Hayes sharks it and bangs it inside 50. Holding his ground, Schwartz did well. Ward comes in. Wrapped up by Riewoldt. What a tackle. Great tackle from Nick Riewoldt. And they have gone up a notch, the Saints.
And after a very quiet start and a heavy knock, Lenny Hayes has now accumulated 16 possessions. He's really providing some drive in the midfield for the Saints.
So ball's bounced straight up. Ruckman missed it. Bizzle took it. He's wrapped up in the end. And we will get a ball up again. Just inside 50 for the Saints. Just as the Demons looked like they were pulling away. Jeff White there on screen. Being attended to. But just as they were starting to pull away, it looked like they were getting on top. St Kilda have hit back. Harvey through the traffic. He's normally good. He's real good. The Saints to lead. What a beautiful finish. What a champion. And Robert Harvey comes up with his first goal.
Well, if there is a weakness in Robert Harvey's game, it's perhaps his finishing or his kicking, but he showed great poise. He's just loitering at the back here. No one within 5 metres of him, and just showed enough poise to get around Walsh and kick the goal. And St Kilda, well, they've kicked the last 3 goals and have finished off the second quarter, much the way they finished the first. And Melbourne really need to just consolidate. They've been killed out of the centre at the moment. They need to get this one forward and at least give their forwards a chance.
Fifth lead change for the match. 8-6 plays, 7-6. The Demons under the pump with Jeff White on the bench. Jolly doing the right work. Armstrong out to Johnston. He's been one of their best today. His 15th possession takes them in the vicinity of Brad Green, who takes a wonderful mark in amongst plenty of pressure. And a bit of dissension there from the Saints in terms of whether there may have been some foreign hands on the ball as well as Brad Green's, but the umpire pays the mark.
No, he did very well there, Green. Just backing back into the pack, got first hands on the football. That was a courageous effort because the cavalry were arriving. He stood his ground, and a goal Melbourne desperately need.
He's taken 5 marks for the day. Just the 1 goal so far. Time to kick another one. Brad Green certainly thinks so. Demon fans and the umpire agrees. 8-6
54, both St Kilda and Melbourne. It was level at quarter time. Talk about mirroring quarters, Michael. 4-3 to each side in the first quarter and 4-3 to each side in the second. Now, Jeff White's on the bench. Question without notice to Christy Malthouse. Do we know what the problem is? Is it just some work or is he having a rest?
He's just having a rest. He had a bit of a rub down there, but he's just having a rest. Obviously, he's had a couple of weeks off, so just a rest.
And one of the great barometers of this Melbourne side is Travis Johnston. 15 possessions this afternoon as we look at the Melbourne bench, but he's been fantastic, Travis Johnston.
Quite a few goals have been scored, just coming clearly out of the middle. Winning the football out of the centre bounce. Johnson, arms clear, no. Brought to ground, no free. And we'll get a ball up again. And a lot of the more important players, one being Travis Johnson for the Demons, coming to the fore. Cameron Bruce, the other player that's starting to get, has had a little bit of the ball. David Neates, naturally, four goals. Jolly back away from goal. Lenny Hayes wrapped up. And we go again. Lenny Hayes, 16 possessions in total, three marks. Certainly been a pretty good supplier for the Saints. Has won a lot of the ball from the centre forward, so has been certainly a constant supplier so far. Lenny Hayes will jump now, doing it all. Heffernan straight into the air. Out front, Hutchins there. Harvey may get there before anyone. Ball set up. Allowed Johnson time to come in to tackle. Players go in. Ozzie Jones gives it up. Green keeps it in. So Demons do well. Missed Walsh in the end. Ozzie Jones, body in front of the ball. Lawrence through the traffic well. Chance to go in the middle. Goddard starting to get a bit of it. Over the top. So the Saints just sharing it around. Black chips up again. Peckett. And with that, now's time for teammates to get forward of the ball. So Peckett has Baker in the middle. And I'll take the chance. He'll load up into half forward. No, goes to Stephen Baker now. Go to the opposite side wing, southern stand side.
Jolly just sitting across St Kilda's half forward line. That's why they're just reluctant to kick to that true centre half forward position.
So Voss now just forward a wing. Rewalt sitting off screen outside 50. He should be their target because he has Bizzle as an opponent. Clearly the advantage there. And Voss is holding it because Jolly has dropped back inside 50. Saints just happy to share it around. Maguire. So again, just holding up. Taking too much time, the Saints. As the siren goes for half time, and it doesn't get any closer than this. It's 86-54 apiece. Nick Rewalt looking a bit frustrated. I think that man, Neil Danaher, should be pretty happy with the way his charge has gone about it. David needs four goals. Good half of football.
Michael, who's just in a word, who's on top, do you think? Don't tell me it's just because the scores are level again.
Well, I'm leaning towards St Kilda because I just think they look more dangerous and more polished when they go forward. But they've conceded starts in the opening two quarters to Melbourne. And Melbourne have looked pretty good. But St Kilda, through the midfield, Hayes, Black and also Robert Harvey, have been able to hit back and take control of that part of the ground. But to Melbourne's credit, they're fighting very hard, led by their captain, David Schwartz, who kicked four goals. David Neates, who kicked four goals in that opening half. So it's all set for a great second half, but leaning towards the Saints at the moment.
Scores are level. We're back for more comments from Michael Christian and a chat to Robert Shaw in just a moment. As a conscience show. If you've ever thought about being a goal umpire, that's the sort of view you might have. Melbourne and St Kilda. Half-time at the MCG. Scores are level. Very interesting match. Both sides kicking four goals, three each in each of the quarters. Boys, what's your feeling on it?
Saints, for me, I just think they're looking very dangerous at times when they go forward. And I just think with the height and explosiveness they've got in their forward half, that it may be enough. But, gee, I tell you, full credit to Melbourne. They're fighting hard, and Jeff White's been fantastic. Neil Danaher just giving his players a last second rev up before the quarter starts.
Yeah, that wasn't recorded from quarter time or anything. That was live out on the field. I haven't seen that very often anyway. I can't remember seeing a coach be out there with the boys after half time. Normally does all his talking in the rooms. Let's get down to Christy, who's on the bench as Neil Danaher goes past.
Well, there's no real injury concerns for either team. The main concern from the first half was probably Darren Jolly. He copped a heavy knock in the first term in the stomach, was sick on the ground before he came off, and probably because of that Lee Colbert injury a couple of weeks ago, the medicos were pretty concerned, took him off, assessed him, and then said, no, he's OK. And he did return to the field in the first half and played OK, so he'll be right for the second half. The other one was Jeff White. He spent a bit of time on the bench. He came off and adjusted his new shin guard. But apart from that, I'm assured that, no, it's just rotation. He's just being rested because he's had 2 weeks off, and he'll be right in the second half as well.
Thanks, Christy. Yes, Jeff White back out in the middle to do battle with Noble. What have you made of Jeff White's performance and indeed Noble's, Mike?
I think Jeff White's been fantastic. He's played a lot in the midfield, allowing Darren Jolly just to drop back in the defensive 50 for Melbourne. But he's been able to link the play up. His first quarter in particular was fantastic. He had 8 possessions at just 11 to half time, but he's played very well.
Demons making a late change. They've whipped Daniel Ward onto the ground and Nicholson off. So the Saints obviously restructuring up forward.
And one of the reasons is Xavier Clark will play out of the goal square. Nathan Burke is also headed down there. And Ward, who's just come on, straight to Schwartz.
Second half from the MCG. Scores level at the moment. A lot to look forward to for both Melbourne and St Kilda. Jeff White and Noble crashing in. Noble, Powell up to half forward. Milne, well, his fortunes change. Ball bounced pretty nicely for Whelan. Put the head down the bottom up. Well played, Stephen Milne. Schwartz perhaps could have tackled rather than going for the bump. Brown, oh, some magic tricks being displayed by Ferguson. He didn't take the footing with him all the way. Milne just...
frustration.
Yeah, a little bit over-vigorous perhaps. And he gets a bit of treatment back from Ferguson. A bit of pushing and shoving. Not much serious stuff to worry about. Ball back into play after we saw the replay there. Godfrey just poked it around the corner. Harvey, good crunching bodywork from the Demons. It was Robertson creating the space. Godfrey relishing in it. Looking up with Ward, who sends it in style down to Green. At full tilt, he took the mark, was able to run the arc, put it out in front of the captain, and the captain does the rest.
Bruce
in the square on his own. He could pass to him, but I think he just decided that he would be better off to go back and put it through for a goal.
Now, Max Hutchton is the man with the job on Brad Green in this third quarter, and it's a matchup that worries me in the sense I don't know that Hutchins got the speed to go with Brad Green. And with Gary back on Neitz, that's a real worry for the Saints.
David Neitz has just enjoyed getting out there and kicking the footy after all his dramas. 5 goals!
Yes, well, good play from Daniel Ward. They mucked around a little bit at half-back, the Melbourne side. But Daniel Ward just burst, ran a good 10 metres and just drove it long. And Green, you can just see there a couple of metres out on Hutchton. And again, getting the ball in quickly. And that's the key. If Melbourne can do that, they're very dangerous because it gives David Neitz every possible opportunity.
So the Demons have started well in this third quarter. Brad Green with an early touch, Neitz with another. So they lead Bruce over the top. Heffernan. Milne runs him down. So loose ball. Lenny Hayes bounces away from him. Baker was there. Hayes will just bomb into the air. Kaczynski will come at the ball. Feeder plays just outside 50. Kaczynski. Powell's there. And the Saints will just hold it in. So it's half forward out of side.
I want to come back to Brad Green, Michael, because his record against St Kilda is great. In 4 games, he's kicked 5 goals, 4 goals, 3 goals and 4. He's kicked 2 today and he's kicked a lot of great, done a lot of great work delivering inside the 50.
Yes, no, he's certainly an outstanding talent, Brad Green. I think he'll end up playing in the midfield, but playing as a permanent forward certainly creates plenty of opportunities.
So Noble down, toe poking, it was Powell. Rewald goes in, well done. Was McDonald on the ground for the Demons. We're back in the square and we will get another ball up.
And they're the things that coaches love to see. James McDonald just committing his body 100% to try and trap that football.
So Walsh with a job, and Heath Black in that first half of football. Keckett just peels off on this ball up. Ball will come down. Ozzie Jones running away from goal. Contest on. McDonald with a job there, so it seems. Ozzie towards a boundary. McDonald does enough. Does he keep it in? He did in the end. He did well off the ground, Walsh. So pretty scrambly. Oh! Might have been Ozzie Jones. Too high. Johnson. Thompson. Oh, too high from Black. And it could well be. Might have been Heath Black in the end, but boy, were the players willing.
Flying elbow there.
So it's 25 from goal. Green with his back to it, and it'll go to the Saints. Advantage paid. Lawrence and St Kilda go into attack.
Saints surging here, and they need to. Lawrence off half back. He had Milne at centre half forward, and they just break down as Uze reads it nicely. Takes the mark, gets the release and kick, but it was poor. Jeff White bemused on the wing screen, wanting to kick it to me. Meantime, Lawrence and Goddard able to combine and get it into Noble, who fell over. At the crucial stage, Baker found a path, set the task for Frankie Peck, and he couldn't take it. Uze, controlled it beautifully. Well played, Adam Uze, setting up the rebound. Walsh, they're going to link up through Miller. Scotty Thompson only touched it once for the day. His second touch is long and not quite strong enough. It's a behind.
It's a poor finish from Thompson. Robertson was all by himself in the forward pocket. And he just blazed away.
So ball will come back. Climate signs are good for the Demons. So, Chris-O, who do you like? Saints?
No, I'm sticking with the Saints.
So short again, Goddard. They do need to get the ball to this guy. Beautiful kick, good user. Out wide, Black will take it. So moves on quickly, the left footer. Robertson does enough just to hold him up. Riewoldt with the sit, and Riewoldt will mark. So they've got it to half forward, St Kilda. Have to move it quickly. So Riewoldt to load up. It's into the corridor. Kaczynski, White does beautifully to get back. Xavier Clark, Ward. And again, Demons, Uze. Cameron Bruce, and they have a little bit of run into the middle. So Cameron Bruce with two bounces. Neitz with a bit of space. That's where he heads. And Neitz will mark. They moved it beautifully off half-back Demons. Good use of the ball. Uze with a touch. And David Neitz with a chance for goal number six.
And just watching Cameron Bruce come through the midfield there, he thought a couple of times about giving a handball away, and luckily he didn't, because he got the ball in quickly, gave Neitz a chance because it was open. And David Neitz a big chance to kick goal number six.
Robert Harvey's in trouble, he's off. We'll get back to that in a moment.
So Neitz, whose kicking has been spot on again. He kicks another, and that's six. His kicking has been spot on, and at times could be absolutely terrible. But David Neitz is on song. He has six, and the Demons have a 13-point lead.
You just watch Cameron Bruce. A couple of sideways glances, but Melbourne have been very direct there. And David Neitz, what a game. He's been under extreme pressure in the last couple of weeks on a number of different fronts. But to come out today and kick six goals in the early part of the third quarter, great effort.
The news gets worse for St Kilda fans. Robert Harvey going to the rooms for some treatment. We'll get more details from that in a moment. We saw him just go down sore after that tackle on Travis Johnston. And that is not a good sign for the Saints. They trail by 13. I guess the only positive, Michael, is that this has happened in every quarter so far. The Demons have got away and the Saints have been able to hit back. The margin out to 13, though, and Noble trying to get them going. Hayes... a handball. Bruce has been great. White just smashing them forward. Miller got a touch to it. And then he wraps up Brett Voss. It's interesting, Michael, this is the fourth game that the Saints have played without their captain Aaron Hamill this year. And they haven't won any of them yet so far. They've lost their other three.
Well, they dearly love him out there today. He just adds so much in terms of inspiration and leadership.
Who will be the leaders with Harvey off for the Saints? If they're to get back. Lenny Hayes, certainly one of them. He's the acting captain today. Powell, Walsh.
I'd like to see Xavier Clark either coming off a wing. He's playing out of the goal square, out of the play at the moment, or coming off half-back.
Had a quiet day, Clark, just the two possessions.
as Lawrence switches to him. As if on cue, he takes the mark and then gets it long. In towards Kaczynski. Heffernan did well. It was courageous. Didn't mark it. Milne. Powell, an important touch. Thompson. Burke. Tough to beat two here. Riewoldt was late on the scene. Again, he's confronted by demons in the boundary line as Bissell takes it over and out. We go down to Christy Malthouse for an update on Robert Harvey.
Well, as you saw, Robert Harvey was taken down to the Melbourne rooms because they're the closest rooms to get treatment on his right knee. It's actually cut and bleeding at the front, so he's received a heavy knock to it, but he was limping quite a bit and looked like he was in a bit of pain, so it's probably quite bruised as well.
Here's a chance for Brown. He runs the gauntlet, and then he thought, no, the gauntlet's a bit much for him, and I'm going through for a behind.
And the move's been made. Hudson has gone back on to David Neate, something we talked about a little earlier. It frees up Gehrig to play in attacking 50 for St Kilda, and I think that's where Fraser Gehrig's going to be at his most damaging. And I actually didn't think Hudson had done a bad job or Neate's to start with, and I think the move was, in hindsight, premature.
We saw Aaron Hamill in the box there behind Dean Wallace and the Saints. Now we're looking at Clint Bissell. And what's ahead? And once again, Michael, as you mentioned earlier, the Saints prepared to concede the short kick in. It's the next couple of kicks that becomes the problem then for the defensive side.
Well, we've got Riewoldt and Noble, St Kilda just banked across between halfback and wing where this kick will go, and it gives the Saints a good chance to repel it.
And Riewoldt's normally great at reading that. He didn't quite get near that one. The kick was a little askew. Hurried kick forward by Leoncelli. His first for the day, amazingly enough, wasn't a memorable one. Black can put it lace out to Milne, who hasn't had much of a sniff. He goes for a pass. Oh, Clark's got spring. Couldn't take the mark, though. Powell, they're leaving it behind at the moment, the Saints. And this rebound and run coming for the Demons. Whelan and Walsh have been terrific. Up to half-forward, Robertson been relatively quiet. Still working hard, though. Bruce and Miller have been good. Goddard for the Saints. He's had 12 possessions now. Ozzie Jones, 19. Leading the way on the ground. Clark got some treatment from Thompson. Wanted to move it. Move it quickly. Did. Here's Hayes, puts the foot down, Lenny Hayes, guides it to Riewoldt, ball's in safe hands there, as Nick Riewoldt takes the mark.
And St Kilda a little lucky to turn it over. Good play from Voss, putting his body in on the wing, and Goddard. But Stephen Milner, just a few moments ago, perhaps would have been better advised to go back and shoot for goal rather than trying to invent a pass. But big chance here for the Saints.
Oh, some hesitation. Riewoldt
not confident.
Thinking about the pass. There's the reverse angle to see what he has ahead.
Tough shot.
One behind for the day from Nick Riewoldt. Interesting approach. Successful one. Unusual, but a goal. Is this kicking technique in the coaching manual, Michael?
Well, his aim certainly was to try and keep it low. As we've mentioned throughout the season, very difficult to kick goals from the angle at the City End, and good play from Hayes, just accelerating there, and great vision just to put it out in front of Riewoldt, and a great finish by Riewoldt in the end. Perhaps didn't come off the boot as he had liked, but a goal nonetheless.
So back to 6 points. Nick Riewoldt with his first goal of the game, and Lenny Hayes had a little bit of time just coming out of the square, able to pinpoint him. That's where St Kilda need to get it. Burke through the traffic. Whelan will lead Murray off the ground. Overran it. Heffernan back to Bruce was good. Over the top. So sharing it to Thompson. On the end of the chain was Leoncelli. Over the top. Miller into half forward. Overuse of the ball. Could be. They still have possession though. McDonald back out again. Miller slaps it into the path. Oh, Bruce beautifully through the traffic. Let it go. And a chance now for the Saints to repel. Lawrence takes his time. What's his left foot like? Good, Riewoldt. It's actually free going kick to Melbourne. Something off the ball, Chris O.
Yeah, free kick off the ball against Goddard for a hold.
So McDonald and the Demons just forward of the wing.
Robert Harvey's re-emerged from the rooms, by the way, and he's running along the boundary. We'll get an update on that shortly.
So good sign for the Saints. Need him out there. Pulling long, meets a target. Overrunning at Ferguson, loose ball Thompson. It's inside 50, scramble from both teams, and we will get a ball up. Lenny Hayes there for the Saints. Nathan Burke just encouraging his teammates, Robert Harvey. And again, the game just could have swung ever so slightly with that last goal, but nothing in it. Through the traffic, Goddard, Burke on again.
Thompson. Shocking kick, Walsh. And Peter Walsh with a chance. Kicking can be astray at times from outside 50. It's up into the air. It's long. And it's a goal. It is a goal. So Walsh comes up with his first goal. And again, Melbourne push it out by 12 points. And what a shocking kick in the end, St Kilda coming out of defence. Good pressure from the Dudes.
Well, I think that's the operative word, Dakes. There was pressure. The got out handball put Thompson right under the pump. Well, sorry, the Burke handball. And he was just pushed off right at the moment of impact. So an unfortunate mistake there. Great pressure from Melbourne and a great finish from Walsh.
So there's Robert Harvey. The Saints would dearly love to get him out there again. He hasn't had a day to remember so far. 10 possessions. The Saints are trailing now by 12. Leoncelli suddenly getting busy. Out of the middle. Brown guiding it for Miller.
It's been good, this guy.
70 from goal. Miller has taken 6 marks. Hudson did the job that time on Meats. Lawrence. Johnston finds a path and then goes for a pass. Walsh, who got the last one, surrounded by Saints. Could have given away a free then. He has. Advantage will not be paid.
And just talking about Melbourne before the game, about ranking 16th in terms of number of goal kickers. Walsh was only their 5th of the day. They need a few of the other players like Robertson to stand up.
We saw Robert Harvey. He's back on the ground. Powell dancing around on the wing. Goes to half forward on Murray.
Good mark.
Terrific grab. Started his career at St Kilda in such glorious fashion against the Hawks a few weeks ago. Kicked the opening goal of the day.
Jeff White just dropping back in the hole.
He's found the going a bit tougher since then. He's kicked 6 goals for the year. He really winds into this one. Gives it everything, and everything was almost enough. Not quite a behind. The Saints 9-8-62. The Demons 11-7-73. Saturday afternoon footy from the MCG. Hope you're enjoying it around the country. Robert Harvey, as we said, back on the ground.
And Stephen Milne taken off after perhaps just lairising a bit a few moments ago.
So Bizzle getting that shot, and they just work it into that pocket again. So McDonald up and again, pretty well covered. St Kilda just zoning and manning up. McDonald across the ground, it's dangerous. Harvey's there, but it should get to Walsh. It does. So what Walsh to load up, needs to use it, and he does and will, and third down the ground will mark. So they've got it between half back and wing. Whelan, who was seen off Stephen Milne into half forward. Well done, Robertson. Came out, charging out to mark it. Strong hands. Short, dangerous, funny kick. Noble was there, couldn't trap it. Still in dangerous area for the Demons. White dropped it in the end. Great pressure, too high in the end. Out of jail for the Demons. Bizzle will take it. Bizzle just over the top to Jeff White. He's pretty happy that they still have possession. Robertson half forward. Nicholson back close to Neeson. I don't know whether that's a good sign. It's short, so sharing it around. Cameron Bruce to load up. He heads into the pocket. Nicholson will jump. No, flat-footed Neeson. And that worked well for Hutchinson because he'll see it over the line.
Looked like Kaczynski had followed, gone all the way down there, Dakes, to try and help out his teammate. There's Leoncelli back on the bench. After coming on, he's had a really quiet day. Just the four possessions for the day, none in the first half. Double fister from Riewoldt. Just eased the squeeze a bit for the Saints. Gained them some territory. Third quarter, Melbourne have kicked 3 goals, 1. St Kilda, 1 goal, 2. Nathan Burke finding a place on the bench alongside Stephen Milne.
Critical period of the game here, particularly for St Kilda. They can't allow Melbourne to kick a couple of goals because they find it very difficult to come back.
They're able to come back, weren't they, in the first couple of quarters. Clark. Still nothing doing, and yet again we're going to have a bounce.
The difficult thing, Hutto, is to can they continue to do it for a third and fourth quarter, so they really need the next goal, St Kilda.
Well, most of the players on the field are in the vicinity of the ball at the moment, certainly in the forward half for the Demons. And the umpire's got fed up and he's plucked out a free out of all that.
They're virtually sitting on his back. How was Lenny Hayes supposed to get that out? But Demons again with numbers. That's been a good feature of their game today.
Thompson sets it up. Can someone take a run? It was Bruce with a desperate lunge. He just couldn't quite get there. And the Saints able to take it over and out.
Kaczynski was good back there, Chris O.
Yes,
that third man up.
Absolutely. And I mean, he's one player that they certainly need. He's meant to be playing up forward. He's trying to get out. And just noticed the runner there telling him to stay inside defensive 50 just to try and clog it up a little bit.
Well, clog it up is what they've been able to do. Voss's kick comes out. Mainly Demons across half forward. Schwartz, Harvey all over running it. Short ball handling from Bruce. And now McDonald spots the lead from Miller. Miller after it. Goddard after him. The handball, the idea was great. Couldn't quite get Whelan. Now Boston Goddard. He really looks like he knows what he's doing when he's got the footy under his arm. Lawrence was there to provide backup. Out to Kaczynski. The Saints by stealth work it forward. Hayes for Murray. The next option, not immediately obvious. Gehrig is back forward. Makes a lead. Rewald the target. Rewald the opportunity. You don't have to give him much of a chance. And Bizzle just allowed him to slip away. And Rewald can get one back here for the Saints.
He has to be the target, Crusoe, going in. Well, you have to be patient, allow him to just reposition himself.
Absolutely. And it was great play from Murray because he wouldn't have been able to reach Rewald if he had have gone behind the mark, but he took the initiative, played on, gained 7 or 8 metres, and that was enough that he needed to be able to deliver the ball effectively to Rewald.
It may have been a fraction fortunate to be paid his 8th mark of the day there, Nick Rewald. But the all-important thing is he was paid, and now he's kicking a goal. And it's the Saints' 10th for the day. St Kilda, Melbourne 11-7-73. It's a 5-point ball game, and once again, the Saints able to erase the lead that the Demons have managed to build.
Well, 2 goals to Nick Rewald. And just look at Murray here. There he goes, just gains 5 metres, and that was just what he needed to be able to get the ball to Rewald. And perhaps a little lucky to be paid, but 2 goals in the quarter to Rewald, keeping the Saints in the game.
Well, just so important this game to St Kilda. When you consider coming into it, their percentage was 87.3 or thereabouts. So they can ill afford to drop a game. Jolly keeps it in front of himself. Well done, Maguire. Hands off. Harvey didn't have it. Demons through Uze. Members side looking for Walsh. And Walsh will mark it. So into half forward. Miller. Oh, that's a good mark. Goddard right with him. Clearly an advantage there for Miller. Inside 50. Green came out. Just doing enough was Troy Schwartz.
He's a good matchup, Schwartz, on Green. Just got the pace to go with him and evidence home. There just with the closing speed to be able to affect the spoil.
A lot of the opposition teams will, a lot of the times, will try and get the tall on Troy Schwartz and drag him back to the goal square. So well done, Maguire, who hasn't been too bad. Chris O.
No, I think
for the Saints, he's certainly contested.
No, he really does give them a fantastic contest. Now, the umpire's just conferring here because the ball was punched out on the full, so it's a free kick to Johnston of Melbourne.
Well, he still has plenty of the goals open to him here. He'll kick from about 45.
He's the sort of player that
and this will
could,
be a
could kick it.
So Johnson just sneaks in, and sneaks in enough for a goal! Well, Travis Johnson, not to be outdone by his skipper in the first half, comes up with a doozy. And with that, Melbourne able to jump out again.
I tell you what, it was better than a doozy. That was a fantastic kick for goal. Well, we had a great look at it. And there you see the ball just bouncing over the line. And Travis Johnston knew it was a free kick. And here's the finish. A sensational finish. He knew it right from the moment it left the boot. And we talked at halftime about how important he is to this Melbourne side. 5 possessions now in this third term. and a key barometer and a valuable goal to the Demons.
And Melbourne's sixth goal kicker for the day, and we talked at the start of the game about how important it is they find other avenues to goal apart from David Neates. Straight away, Travis Johnson swamped. Great to see him back in form, though. 20 possessions today, it takes.
Well, he's been very good, just so important out of your midfield. I mean, the expectation is that out of the midfield, you have to be touching the ball at least 20, 25 times, kicking goals, well, that becomes a bonus. But to the Demons' credit, every time they have been challenged, they've been able to get that extra goal.
Bizzle working hard at ground level. Farming it out for Godfrey, who gets it in the direction of Armstrong. Ball eluding Meats. Tough one for Hudson to control. He did it pretty well. Plenty of air on the handball to Voss, enough to make him a little nervous. Walsh also with the fumbles. Johnston again in the right position. Demons arms up everywhere. Good spoil from Black. Jones left it behind. Green. Clark. Ball up. Clark asking the question about whether or not Green was on top of it, and he dragged it under. The umpire said no.
And just moments ago, Brett Voss, who has had showed lots of poise and coolness today, just panicked a bit there and scrambled a kick. It could have cost them a goal, but they're still alive.
Yeah, 11 points the margin of the MCG. Armstrong from stage left kicks a wonderful goal. Oh, what a snap from Armstrong. Umpire gives it the all clear. And the Demons, through Stephen Armstrong, break the drought for the day on teams kicking more than four goals in a quarter. Four in the first, four in the second, and now five in the third. More importantly, the margin is back out to 17 as we get close to three-quarter time.
Well, Hutto, their seventh goal kicker, and it's something we've focused on today and something that would please Neil Danaher, but it is their second biggest lead of the match. They led by 20 points at the 14-minute mark of the first quarter, and now a big challenge in front of St Kilda.
So, ball to be bounced again. And we made mention of Travis Johnson and his game so far. There he is on screen. Aside from winning the ball and kicking a great goal, he's put the brakes on Lenny Hayes. So he's doing well. Rewalt, Harvey, quick kick out, use of the body, Peckett then tries to run onto it, allowed it to run. Johnson again back there. Brown to Bizzle and out wide. Numbers with Melbourne, Heffernan, half forward, and Miller will mark. He certainly added something across half forward, presented himself, and has been pretty strong. It's in long, Voss is there, and Neates makes it his very own. And the Demon skipper has six in this game. Melbourne starting to take control, and he will line up for goal number seven from about 30 metres.
Well, David Neates, he's been absolutely superb today. Just judging it better than his St Kilda opponents, but it all started by Travis Johnston in the centre.
So, Neates, there's your view and there's your goal. So the Demons, thanks to their skipper, starting to take control. They're winning around the ground and, more importantly, putting it on the scoreboard.
Well, Melbourne's biggest lead of the match, and what a game from that man, David Neates. Came into the game just kicking two goals in the last 3 weeks, and certainly a player that Melbourne really needed to stand up today, lead from the front, and he's answered all the challenges. Now let's have a look at this. Travis Johnson on Peckett, just got his hand in there to prevent it getting away, knocked it to Nathan Brown, and that's where Melbourne's attack started. It ended up with Miller, who got the kick away to Neates, and a great running goal, a great set shot goal to David Neates.
So David Neates, what a return from him this afternoon. After the break, seven goals. Enough to give the Demons a 23-point advantage. And the ball's going forward. Miller's been great. Out to Heffernan. The shackles are off for the Demons. There's Heffernan blasts another one. Chris Heffernan provides Melbourne's 15th goal, seven for the quarter, and there's nothing Aaron Hamill can do, the captain of the Saints, when he's sitting in the coach's box.
Well, they've kicked four goals in the last 5 minutes, and they've found four additional goal kickers in this third quarter, which was so important. And, well, they're full of run, they're full of, confidence at the moment, Melbourne, and Gee, it's a long way back now for St Kilda.
So as we approach three-quarter time, it is all the Demons. What a lead they will take in to the last quarter. It comes out Heffernan, but he's back to goal. He's wrapped up by Xavier Clark. Loose ball off the ground by Walsh. Cameron Bruce in and out of traffic, and then over the top, Goddard. No, good strong mark, Godfrey. So backing back, Demons not done with the Saints just yet. Into the corridor, loose ball. They are mopping everything up. Jolly, the ruckman, hands off to Green. Around the body, good kick. That's a great kick. And Travis Johnson, even after the ball hadn't been securely won across half forward, had run forward, and now will go back from about 35.
I'll tell you one player who's made a huge difference this afternoon, and that's been Brad Miller. He was involved earlier on in that passage of play, just shepherding to allow a teammate to take the mark. But he's taken eight marks and has been absolutely fantastic across half forward for Melbourne.
Six centre breaks to two for the quarter two in favour of the Demons.
And that's been the key. Travis Johnson with a goal. He has kicked his second of the quarter. And it has been a big third quarter of football from the Demons. They have a stranglehold on this game.
Well, they've kicked five goals in the last 6 minutes, Melbourne. Really, to put the game, well, you wouldn't say beyond doubt, but it's going to be extremely difficult for St Kilda. And Travis Johnston, just see him in the background of the screen there, running hard from midfield to get into a position where he's was able to present to Green. And, gee, it must be frustrating for Neil Danaher, because at his best, Travis Johnston is as good as any midfielder in the competition. But unfortunately, his form can be very inconsistent, but today he's been a star.
Well, what will the St Kilda Brains Trust come up with now? They're dominating out of the middle. Jolly thrusting them forward again. Black trying to do something about it. Cameron Bruce, they're toying with them, the Demons. And Cameron Bruce gets another goal. It's an avalanche at the MCG. Team that's out there, Michael.
Well,
have they been?
It's just incredible, isn't it? Six goals in the last 7 minutes. Another goal kicker to the list. And they're just dominating out of the centre. They're doing everything right. But the real question now is St Kilda. They beat Brisbane 3 weeks ago. Went down to Port Adelaide. But they have established themselves as genuine finals contenders, but in the last 7 or 8 minutes, they have been ripped apart.
So Jolly has been fantastic out of the middle, gives a contest again. Riewoldt, Thompson, Lenny Hayes, and that's probably one thing they can do. As a siren goes, it has been a big third quarter of football from the Demons, and why wouldn't they be happy? They will take a 41-point lead into the last quarter, and you certainly couldn't see St Kilda getting back from this.
Well, they started the third quarter, kicked a couple of early goals, and St Kilda were able to hit back. We thought, well, is this a repeat of the first half where Melbourne got out to a lead? St Kilda were able to peg them back. And for a moment, it looked as though that would happen with Riewoldt kicking a couple of goals. But from the 23-minute mark to the 30-minute mark, Melbourne kicked six goals unanswered and just dominated out of the centre. They dominated in the midfield. But more importantly, the way they played, they were direct. They got the ball quickly into their forward 50 and gave their forwards, Green, Neats, every possible opportunity to convert.
A brilliant third quarter from the Demons. 9-2. The only thing that could be in the back of some people's mind is they've been terrible in last quarters this year. I wonder if that gives the Saints some hope. You wouldn't think so. The margin's 41, but who knows? Neil Danaher's a happy man at the moment. Will he be at the end of the day? We'll find out shortly.
Yeah, I feel like the force of nature could make you sing like a bird released. If what you seek is the wise man's treasure, you know it's buried beneath.
Goals. Enough to give the Demons a 23-point advantage, and the ball's going forward. Miller's been great. Out to Heffernan. The shackles are off for the Demons. There's Heffernan's last another one. Oh, it's a funny game footy, isn't it, if you're a Melbourne supporter? 9-2. Where have they been for the last, 10 weeks or so? Great quarter, though. 17-7-109. They really smashed them out of the middle. St Kilda, 10-8-68.
as we're getting ready for the third quarter. We've had the third quarter, getting ready for the last quarter here. Michael, great quarter by the Demons, but what about the Saints?
Well, they've been very disappointing. They've conceded starts in each of the quarters, and in that third quarter, they just fell away. And that's a look at what they confront in the next month. Essendon, Sydney away, Kangaroos and Adelaide away, and that is a very hard run. So if they concede today's game, you've really got to say that they put in jeopardy any chance of playing in the finals in September. This is a game they had to win today, and unfortunately at the moment for St Kilda fans, they're looking down the barrel 41 points behind. I think the other thing to mention, Hutto, Hamill was a big loss to them. Luke Penny, who's given them some real stability at centre-half-back, he's been sorely missed. And it's no coincidence that when Robert Harvey went off the ground midway through that third term was about the time that the Melbourne side, particularly in the midfield, started to have a real impact.
But they were giving a yelp in the first half. I mean, that just completely disintegrated.
What will their response be in the final term? Can the Saints make a run at it? The margin is 41 points and Kaczynski is in the ruck now. Grant Thomas has had... Well, he's had trouble finding a ruckman, certainly in the third quarter, to be competitive. And now Kaczynski with the job. As the Demons first going forward, but now the Saints able to rebound to Goddard, being pursued by Heffernan. Couple swinging past. Let's hope the wheels don't fall off for the Saints. I'm sure it won't. Here's McDonald taking the mark.
You sure on that?
Well, you'd hope not. That's... They've shown too much this year to let it all fall away as the season gets towards the end of the year. Robertson gets it in long and gets it in strong. Bruce in great position to mark. Did everything but take it. He feeds it out to Green, who just kicked perhaps a little bit quickly and out of bounds on the full as we go down to Christy Malthouse.
Well, Robert Harvey has started on the ground in this final term, as you can see. He was the one who came off in that last quarter. He had a heavy collision to his right knee. It was cut and bleeding and bruised, as we said. He went down to the rooms, had it fixed up, and he's back out on the ground now. But whether he can play out the quarter, that'll be the question.
So, and we're just talking about Robert Harvey with a free kick. Out of side wing, needed early goal, Saints.
Rewalt's gone to full forward. One out in the goal square.
That's where he should be. Got to get it in quick though. Xavier Clark will take it.
Just needs to wheel around onto his left boot and just thump it long into the goals, top of the goal square where Ewald is.
So Clark with the ball. Fairly quiet afternoon by his standards. Short again. Bump ball. Black will go around. Now to supply in. Will take a bounce. Steadies up. Black out wide. No one there. And missing the ball in the end was Robertson. Powell slapping it back, ball over the line.
Just taking too long, St Kilda, to get there. They trail by 41 points. They need to basically play on at all costs in this final quarter, kick the ball long and direct and give Rewalt a chance at full forward.
So ball will come down. Harvey was there. Uze to the boundary again. So Demons happy to see it over the line. They readjust.
And Michael, just their leading goal kickers for the year. Fraser Gehrig, 23 goals. Milne, 22 today. Milne's had three possessions and no goals, and Gehrig, two possessions, one goal.
So Rewalt trying to get around, will take it out of the ruck, then lose it, keep it in, left foot, did well, back to the goal square. Milne held on to it, it's a free to the Demons. It's Ferguson down there against former teammate Stephen Powell. So Ferguson chips up, bizzles away on that outer side, will take a bounce, plenty of time. Rewalt. And there for the Saints, hands off, backpedalling Johnson. Oh, that's a good kick. So they're all going the Demons' way at the moment. Godfrey just chips up, Green comes out, it bounces between he and Neitz. Back to the goal square, that's a good kick, and then Voss will try and rush it through. Demons keep it in, Armstrong, off the ground, Robertson, and they get another behind. So pretty hard going for the Saints at the moment, Russell Robertson. Fair afternoon, certainly been in there. Secured a bench, plenty of concerns at the moment. And a mark to Kaczynski.
Kaczynski from half back gets it up to Milne. And a few extra cheers for Stephen Milne, perhaps some bronze cheers amongst them. Into Thompson, who blazes away, puts it up high. Rewild made his run.
On it.
Claimed it. I don't think Mark did. I think that's a fair decision.
I think Jolly may have just got hands first on the football.
Yes, Peter?
That's a problem with Stephen Milne. If he's not doing well, there's not a lot of other positions that he can play in. And has spent a bit of time on the bench. Rewild, yeah, that was a mark.
Perhaps Jolly touched that first, Dakes.
Perhaps finish the lolly before you make your comment next time, Dakes.
Oh, wasn't he going to eat them all afternoon?
Welsh combining with Bruce, who delays the handball till Walsh was an option. Now back to Johnston. And look at me like that, Peter, as he kicks it to centre half forward. Baker has to work really hard here. Armstrong was good. Schwartz, Green, threw it out, trying to get it to Godfrey, back to Baker. Interesting handball over the top, Hayes. He's just bundled away, and he's going to get a free kick.
You just wouldn't believe that this Melbourne side is the side we've witnessed over the last 11 weeks. It's playing with confidence and poise, particularly after halftime.
Is it just as simple as that almost, Michael, just confidence?
Well, I think it's got a lot to do with it, Hutto, and I think just the way they've played, they've just been so direct and they've got the ball on quickly.
Saints finally finding a way forward here. A gaping hole for Lenny Hayes to work in. Into Rewild. Used his body well free and kick. There was some hanging on. And the Saints fans say, finally, we're going to get a free in front of goal as David Meeks did three times in the first half.
Good use of the body in the end, Rewild. Keeping Bizzle under the ball, and he had to be the target for the Saints for most of this game, but unfortunately been doing so much work up the ground, and good use, and in the end Bizzle, that's all he could do.
So here's Nick Rewald, just manages to keep it in. Nice kick, and the Saints took 5.5 minutes, but they've got a goal. I guess it keeps alive some hope for the Saints.
It does, but you couldn't see it, to be honest, Dev. They really, since halfway through that third term, they just haven't been in the game at all. Good play there from Lenny Hayes, just kicking it long and giving Rewald a chance, and he certainly has stood up today, Nick Rewald. He's taken 8 marks, 13 possessions, and now kicked 3 goals.
So one down, 6 to go for the Saints. Still a big ask. All the play with the Demons at the moment. Kaczynski, Jolly again has been excellent, in particular third quarter. Goddard went through him. Heffernan did enough. Too high on Travis Johnston.
Well, I'd like to have a look at that one again, Dace, because that's a classic ducking your head.
Well, it's just a standard thing, isn't it? You have to protect yourself. Johnston inboard needs Ozzie Jones. Left foot delivers in the end, smothered, good pressure. Hutchinson gave it away, Nicholson. Green, over to Armstrong, left it behind, then picked it up, then to the goal square. Chance for the Demons, there's three there. Slap back, St Kilda will run it away. Clark, out wide, that's a good kick, and Kaczynski with the ball.
Where to next? Kaczynski has to go for a gallop along the wing into Rewald. Bizzle, no free kick that time. Plenty of sweepers for the Demons too, ready to swoop on it. Ward can go to McDonald. It's like circle work, modern footy, isn't it, sometimes?
Good chase.
Had nowhere to go again and had to kick it. Oh, he's going to get a free kick.
It's a pretty good run, the Demons, with Freeze.
15-12 in favour of Melbourne. In fact, 16-12 now as Fraser Gehrig shrugs the shoulders. Wonders about that.
But even in instances like that, there was a couple, one time St Kilda having a shot for goal, and I think it was Ozzie Jones early in the game, early part of the game, and it wasn't paid. So consistency, not there.
Up towards 50, got out in the mugs. Oh, what a mark from the side from Darren Jolly. And he has been a really pleasing sign for Melbourne today. He's had 17 hit-outs. And now, isn't it a lot around the grounds in terms of possessions, but that is a fantastic mark, Michael.
Oh, a sensational mark. He just fixed his eyes on the football and just charged at it. And tell you what, he's been in the wars a bit today too. Copped a very heavy knock in the midriff early on in the game and has bounced back fantastic. And with the White-Jolly combination, with Jolly really emerging now, it's a very potent force for Melbourne.
Just the 3 goals in 9 games for the year for Darren Jolly. Just 2 marks for the day, 3 disposals. Oh, he decides to get the handball off to Heffernan, and he thought about giving it back. Now he does. Oh, Darren Jolly crossed the body. Better stick to ruck work, Darren. as Ozzie Jones takes the mark.
And that's where, I mean, the idea was right, but that's where probably Melbourne were a few weeks ago, or for the majority of the season, overusing it and short. But Powell, to wing it is. Big ask, Harvey. Good use of the body. Push to the front. Ward overran it in the end. Harvey just dribbles it in. Bizzle will come out. Harvey goes in again. And Bizzle, as you'd expect, to the boundary. Giving nothing away, Clint Bizzle. Big job on Riewoldt this afternoon.
He's done pretty well too, Dakes. I mean, Riewoldt's, you know, he's done a fair bit, Riewoldt. 8 marks, 13 possessions, 3 goals. Bizzle has stuck to his task against the odds, and he played it very well there, kept the ball in front of him, and was just able to force it over the line.
Well, one of the problems for the Saints is 18 touches Lenny Hayes had had to halftime, only 24. Ozzie Jones around the same. He's only had 4 touches since that halftime break. Harvey's out of the contest as well. McDonald has grown. Bruce, good, back for some form. Johnson didn't take it. Smart football. Chance out of draw. Evaded one, then hands off to Godfrey. Handed to him on a silver platter. Good kick. Needs will come out. St Kilda player dropping back. Robertson will join the party, and he will kick a point. Just missing to the right.
Gee, that was brilliant play from Travis Johnston on the wing. Just sensed he was going to be tackled, so he tapped it to his own advantage. Here we have a look at it. And just here, got down, got the football, and great evasive skills around Hayes. Brilliant play.
Swartz delivering out of defence to a one-on-one on the wing, or to a none-on-none in the end, as it went over all their heads. Free kick against Heffernan. And no 50-metre penalty. The ball's going to come back to Kaczynski across half-back. Both sides, of course, had a number of players coming back into the team today. One of them, Justin Kaczynski for the Saints. He's had 8 disposals and 5 marks. Goddard, another one who was really good in the first half, been a little quieter since. Maxie Hadston, another player to come back into the team today. Started on Neitz, went away from him, then went back. It's inside 50 and now outside again. Bizzle, Jeff White, trying to switch play. Doomin's got plenty running to this side of the ground. Uze looks at his breadth of options. One of them, Nathan Brown. Run down and gone.
I tell you.
Advantage. Lenny Hayes will take that advantage. Xavier Clark must kick a goal. And he does. The Saints have got 2 for the quarter. It's back to 31 now. They've kicked 2 goals in 11 and a half minutes. Not quite the rate they needed to kick the goals at, but... Well,